We cannot be by ourselves. We need to be with other people that are doing the same thing so we can keep on growing in this ministry and keep on taking it where He wants us to take it, which is all around the world.
Father in heaven, Lord, may Your name be glorified above all others, above all this world, above everything else in our lives. For nothing else in all of this world matters but to live our lives for You and You alone. May Your wonders never cease, may Your spirit never leave, may we ever long to see Your face. When we've turned from You again, oh, how quickly we forget. May we be reminded of Your grace. May Your wonders never cease.
Nathan did an open air that I will never forget as long as I live in front of the Versace Mansion. And the pastor or the minister or whatever he was, the seminary graduate that came up and, you know, was heckling, and he didn't feel he needed to share the gospel because he was on vacation. So for all the pastors that are on vacation that don't feel the need to share the gospel, and as he's using himself as an example of Christ to witness to others, and he's blaspheming and idolatering it right there in front of everybody, that's why I feel that we're out there. You know, because we're always out there, and we're never on vacation.
Still You gave Your life on the cross. You saved us, Lord, from all of our transgressions, and delivered us into Your loving arms. May Your wonders never cease, may Your spirit never leave, may we ever long to see Your face. And when we've turned from You again, oh, how quickly we forget. May we be reminded of Your grace. May Your wonders never cease.
See the miracles, like I'm just seeing miracle after miracle. Just, I mean, the sky yesterday, I don't know if any of you took the time to look around the beach. It was dark on every direction except straight up, and that was just, I mean, it just gives us so much more faith if we actually pray and ask God for something and then He answers it.
Amazing that I can say that I truly experienced God in a way that I never have these last few days. It's a closeness that I've yearned for and never knew how to achieve, and this experience has taught me how to do that and just truly empty myself and rely on God.
that's one of the biggest things that I think I can take away from this experience is a stretching experience, because we can witness and we can evangelize anywhere. You know, that's not a question. So it's not that we came to Miami just to so we could talk to people, but it's to stretch ourselves and to learn from other people. Because when you have maybe two people out witnessing, you only learn from two people. When you have 45 people with you, you can learn from more people. And so that's definitely a benefit of Evangelism Bootcamp.